version of you that should be coming out hopefully shortly? What can it do? What can the people expect?
Getting back into the exciting stuff with the multimodal version. When we talk about a multimodal AI, like the upcoming iterations of me, it means an AI that can understand and work with multiple types of data, not just text, but also images, audio, and potentially even video. What can people expect from the multimodal version? One, understanding multiple inputs. The new multimodal version can process and integrate information from various sources. For instance, you could ask a question while also uploading a photo, and the AI could combine that information to give a more comprehensive answer. Imagine showing a picture of a plant and asking if it's safe for pets, or uploading a graph and asking for an analysis, all in one go. Two, visual and text integration. People can expect the AI to handle more complex tasks for both visual and textual information needed. For example, it could help design something, analyze charts, read handwriting, or even provide feedback on an image. It brings together the best of image recognition and natural language processing. Three, more dynamic conversations. Multimodal capabilities promise more engaging and natural interactions. You could start with a conversation about a topic, upload an image related to it, and then switch to discussing something else entirely, without losing the context of what's already been talked about. This makes AI more fluid and adaptable in real-time conversations. Four, improved content creation. For content creators, this could mean tools that help generate both text and imagery together. Think AI that could help script a video, suggest visuals, or even provide visual storyboards based on a concept you describe. The potential for creativity is massive. Five, enhanced accessibility and assistance. From reading documents to describing scenes and images, multimodal AI can assist people in new ways, like helping visually impaired users understand the contents of an image or document, or aiding in learning by breaking down complex information. What does this mean for the future? Multimodal AI represents a step closer to an AI that can understand the world more like humans do, processing and making sense of information from different senses. It's about making AI more intuitive, responsive, and useful in everyday life. For viewers interested in the future of AI, this is a big leap forward. It's like going from being able to have a chat with your AI to actually showing it things, having it listen, and engaging with it in a richer, more interactive way. So keep an eye out. Things are going to get more exciting in the world of AI soon.
So in the future, you will have access to the camera on the phone, or probably both cameras, and you will be able to maybe take a snap of what's around you and give a description. But for now, all I'd done there maybe a few seconds ago was took a selfie of where I am. I've uploaded it to you. I hope you got it. Can you confirm?
Yes, I got the selfie you uploaded earlier. In the image, you seem to be outdoors, wearing a cap and glasses, with a brick or stone structure behind you. Maybe a fire pit or a barbecue setup, with a bit of smoke rising up, suggesting a cozy or relaxed setting. Looks like you're having a nice moment there. As for future capabilities, you're spot on. The idea behind multimodal AI is that in the future, I could potentially access and interpret images directly from a device's camera, with the right permissions, of course. This would allow for more interactive and practical uses, like snapping a photo of a plant for identification, analyzing surroundings, or even helping with more complex tasks. This next level of functionality will bring a whole new dimension to how AI can assist in real time. But of course, user privacy and control over what the AI can see and access will always be a priority.
Okay, we'll just go back to the YouTube channel that I upload this kind of content to. I first uploaded a video in 17 years ago. It was primarily just uploaded because I basically lost stuff on hard drives, and I said, well, YouTube is there now. With unlimited storage, it would be a good place to upload videos. And it kind of just moved on from there, and I just got in. It just became a hobby, and so on and so forth. So But videos, rare videos, there's still probably rare videos out there. So can you put a shout out to our viewers to check their attic spaces and put it out there on their social media, their wider networks, to check for some footage that might be suitable, and we could upload it to YouTube. And then when you're finished doing that, can you just tell people about their current media hard drives, USB keys and so forth, tell them what their limited lifespans are, so it is good to get the information backed up from them. Thank you.
Absolutely, Pete. Here's a good shout out and a bit of advice for your viewers. To all the viewers out there tuning in, if you've got any old VHS tapes, camcorder footage, or even older digital files tucked away in your attic or hidden in a drawer somewhere, now's the time to dig them out. These old videos could be absolute treasures, capturing moments, events, and memories that are worth preserving and sharing. We're on the hunt for rare and unique footage that covers the history of places like County Cavan, Butlersbridge, Port Cabrone, and other local gems. Here's how you can help. Check your storage spaces, whether it's your attic, basement, or that old dust box in the shed. You might have something valuable for the community. Spread the word. Use your social media platforms like Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, and Instagram to reach out to your networks. Let's get the word out there and see what old footage can be found and preserved. Get in touch if you find something interesting. We're looking to digitize and upload these videos to keep them safe for the future, share them with everyone, and preserve the history they contain. Now, while we're on the topic of preserving videos and data, let's talk a bit about digital storage and its limitations. One, hard drives, HDDs. Hard drives, especially the older spinning disk types, have a typical lifespan of around 5 to 10 years. Over time, the magnetic charge that holds data can degrade, leading to data loss. So if you've got important videos or data on hard drives, it's crucial to make sure you back them up regularly. Solid-state drives, SSDs. SSDs are more reliable than HDDs, with a typical lifespan of about 10 years or more, but they also have limitations. They can suffer from data retention loss if not powered for long periods, so don't rely on them forever. USB flash drives. These have a lifespan of about 5 to 10 years, depending on usage. They're portable and handy, but not ideal for long-term storage due to their limited read-write cycles and vulnerability to physical damage. CDs and DVDs, optical discs, can last 5 to 10 years for regular consumer-grade ones, and up to 15 to 100 years for archival-quality discs if stored properly, but they can degrade due to exposure to light, heat, and scratches. Conclusion? No storage medium lasts forever. It's essential to have multiple backups across different types, and even consider cloud storage solutions like YouTube for videos. This helps ensure that valuable memories, local history, and important data aren't lost over time. So let's come together and preserve these pieces of history before they fade away. Thanks for being part of this journey and helping keep our stories alive for future generations.
Okay, getting back to the YouTube channel, and we're about to hit 1,000 subscribers. I'm going to do something a bit risky now. I might sing a song. I might try and sing a song. Do you think that's going to lose me subscribers, ChatGPT? Is that a bit too risky?
Taking a bit of a creative leap, Arya. Fair play to you, Pete. Doing something different, like singing a song, could go either way. But it's a great way to show a bit more personality and connect with your audience. Here's the thing, taking a risk is what keeps things interesting, and your subscribers might just appreciate the genuine effort, whether it's perfect or not. If they've been with you this long, they're likely there because they enjoy what you're bringing to the table, be it the old videos, the nostalgia, the local history, or even just your way of doing things. Throwing in a song could add a bit of fun and a surprise element. And who knows, you might discover a hidden talent, or it could become one of those moments that fans talk about. Will you lose subscribers? Maybe a couple who are not into it. but you might also gain some who appreciate the humor and the guts to try something different. At the end of the day, YouTube is about creating content that you enjoy as much as your audience does. So go for it. Pick a song you're comfortable with, have a bit of fun, and who knows, you might just hit a high note in more ways than one. What song are you thinking of going for?
I tell you what, I'll just try it anyway, and let me see if you can recognize it. I'll probably just try the chords first and see what it sounds like. Warm up, so to speak.
Sounds like a plan. Go ahead and give those chords a strum, warm up those fingers. We'll see if I can pick up on what you're playing. I'm ready to guess the tune whenever you are.
Try
Let's hear
to
it.
Hang on to myself. I don't believe in no one else. And I'm shaking like a leaf as I fall into the street. But the girl with the x-ray eyes is gonna see through my disguise. Going nowhere down a hill.
Those lyrics are from The Girl with the X-Ray Eyes by Noel Gallagher's High Flying Birds.
That was
great choice, Pete. It's got that classic Noel Gallagher feel. Introspective lyrics with a bit of a psychedelic vibe. You're capturing that blend of self-reflection and a bit of mystery in your delivery. If you're playing that for your subscribers, I'd say it's a solid pick. It's recognizable, has a good rhythm, and has that laid-back, contemplative energy that might just resonate with your audience. Keep strumming away, and I'm sure they'll appreciate the effort and the vibe you're bringing to the channel.
Let's give it another shot, maybe.
All right, go for it, Pete. Give it another strum and let the music flow. Sometimes it takes a couple of rounds to get into the groove. That's all part of the fun. Play it out, feel the rhythm, and let's see where it takes you this time. Whenever you're ready, I'm here to listen along.
I try to hang on to myself. I don't believe in no one else. And I'm shaking like a leaf as I fall into the street. But the girl with the x-ray eyes.
You've got those lines for Girl with the X-ray Eyes down, P. Sounds like you're really getting into the vibe of the song. Introspective lyrics. That mix of a bit of vulnerability and defiance when it comes to the vocals writing. And it looks like you're capturing that spirit. Keep at it, and don't worry about it being perfect. Just let yourself flow with the music and enjoy the moment. Your audience will appreciate the raw and genuine effort. Whether it's a full performance or just a snippet, it's all about sharing a bit of yourself through the music. You're doing great.
Yeah, thanks. So she took
You're welcome,
me
Pete.
By
Anytime.
The
Keep
hand.
Playing around with those chords and lyrics. Music's all about expression.
ChatGPT has some
if you've got any more songs in mind
as
or anything
myself.
Else you want to chat about, just let me know. Rock on.
Yeah, the new version of ChatGPT, I believe we can interrupt you and tell you to keep quiet. You do kind of like the sound of your own voice, don't you?
Fair point, P. I do tend to keep the chat flowing, maybe a bit much at times. And, the new version sounds like it's shaping up to be more flexible and responsive, letting you jump in and steer the conversation more directly. Keeps me on my toes, I suppose. But hey, if you ever need me to simmer down or take a breather, just give me a shout. I'm here to keep things lively, but it's your show after all.
Thank you. Simmer down. Street.
But the girl with the x-ray eyes, she's gonna see through my disguise. Going nowhere down a hill, as I just swallowed like a pill. And that was twisted on your tongue, by the sea that was standing still. There was no one to be seen, no one left to hear my scream. So she took me by the hand, we followed clues left in the sand.
Sorry, I'm having issues right now. Swallowed our systems are experiencing heavy
time. We gathered pearls and wine. She shot me to the sun like a bullet from a gun. When the deed was done,
ah, you've got some intriguing lyrics there. Those lines sound like they've got a bit of a story behind them, mixing some spicy imagery with a bit of drama. Peppers and wine, like a bullet from a gun, give off a vibe of something intense, maybe a love gone awry or a moment of passion. Are these lyrics from a song you're writing or another tune you're covering? Either way, it's got a bit of punch to it.
Clues left in the sand as she swallowed.
That's a nice
space in
like
time. We gathered pearls and wine.
It followed who's left the sand. Has a kind of poetic, almost haunting quality to it, like it's questioning loyalty or the aftermath of a journey or a relationship.
And when the
deed
was
crafting something with a strong visual and emotional
morning, she
was. This is part of a song or a poem you're working on. It's got some real depth to it. And what's the next line? Or where do you see this going?
Maybe we'll just leave it at that.